Hi everyone! Welcome back to integralcalc.com. We're going to be doing another infinite series problem today. This one involves perpetual income streams, so it's like an application of infinite series, which is really interesting. I've written the formula for present value here on the board, and also the formula that we use for infinite series. So the question is, how much do we need to invest right now to establish a perpetual fund that pays $1,000 at the end of every year if the account pays 5% annual interest compounded monthly and we never add to it? So perpetual fund means that forever into eternity, this fund will pay us back $1,000 at the end of every year. It's growing at a rate of 5% annual interest, and the interest is compounded monthly, in other words, 12 times a year. So let's go ahead first and plug that information into our present value formula. And the reason that we're using a present value formula instead of a future value formula is because it asks us how much do we need to invest right now. So we're solving for the present value, what we need to invest now. We're going to plug everything else into the right side of the equation. So we'll say the present value equals, and they want it to pay us back $1,000 at the end of every year. So one way that we can plug in this information, we can say that we're going to get $1,000, and then we'll just put in at the end of 1 year. So the way that we do that, we leave the one. They said that the rate, which is R, was 5% a year, so that's 0.055%. N is the number of times that the interest is compounded each year, and it said it was compounded monthly, so that's 12 times a year. And so then we have here negative N times T, so negative 12 again, and then T, what we're going to do is go ahead and put in 1, because we're looking for $1,000 to be distributed back to us at the end of 1 year. So we can go ahead and plug in a 1 there. So that is the formula for the amount of money that we need to establish in the fund right now for it to pay us $1,000 back at the end of the first year. But we want it to pay us $1,000 back at the end of every year from now until forever. So what that's going to look like is the same thing we have here, 1,000 times 1 plus 0.05 over 12 times negative 12 to the negative 12 times 1, but we also want it to pay us back at the end of the second year and the third year and the fourth year. So theoretically, we could continue to write this same thing to the negative 12 times 2. And this would represent paying us back $1,000 at the end of the second year as well. And we could continue, right, and write what we were going to get back at the end of the third year to the negative 12 times 3. Sorry, that's so crunched. But we could keep going forever. And that would be a representation in infinite series form of the amount, present value, that we need to establish now. So you can see that this is turning into an infinite series. And now that we recognize that it's an infinite series, what we want to do is use our infinite series formula to go ahead and solve for PV, for present value. So the infinite series formula that we always use is first, if we have a series in the form x to the k, where the first value of k is 0 and the series is going to infinity, and the absolute value of x is less than 1, then the series converges to the value 1 over 1 minus x, which right now sounds very confusing, but it's actually not. We take this in three parts. Let's just go ahead and separate these with commas. We take this formula in three parts, and first we look at the first part. We need our series to be in the form x to the k. So the way that we always try to do that is factor our series. So you can see that each term of this series is the same except for this value of t here. So we can factor out the first term, and in fact you usually want to factor out the first term. That's the most common thing that you do. So negative 12 times 1. So if we factor that out, right, if we factor this out of this series, then we're to get this first term here, we multiply by 1, right, because it's the same thing. So 1. And then what would we multiply to get this second term here? Well, we don't need to multiply by 1,000 again because that was factored out here. What we do need to multiply by is 1 plus 0.05 over 12 times negative 12 only. Because if we multiply this term here by this whole thing out in front, we'll have 1,000 times 1 plus 0.05 to the 12, and then this is negative 12 and this is negative 12, so it's the same thing as negative 12 times 2, which is what we have up here. So multiplying this by this gives us this second term. The third term, of course, would be 1 plus 0.05 over 12 times negative 12 times 2, because this exponent and this exponent multiplied together would be negative 12 times 3, which is what we want there. So, and then of course this would continue forever. So we factor the series with the goal of having the series begin with 1. That's the simplest way to go about that, and that's why we factored out exactly what this first term was, so that the first term in the series would then be 1, because 1 times this gives you that first term. So we factor out the first term so that the series begins with 1, because then it's a dead giveaway that this second term right here is our x, and we want to find out what x is so that we can then apply it to these two parts of our formula. So we're always looking at the second term as x, and if you get the series to start with 1 by factoring something out, then it's always the second term here immediately following the 1 that should be your x here. So if that's our x, which it is, then what we need to do is look at the second part of our formula and figure out if the absolute value of x is less than 1. So if we actually do the math in our calculator, 1 plus 0.05 over 12, that whole thing raised to the negative 12, we actually get 0.95 something, which is less than 1. So we know that this formula then applies. The absolute value is less than 1, which means that the series does converge. All that means is that we can calculate the value of the series, which is good for us because we need to find present value. So since it does converge, we can use this formula here, 1 over 1 minus x, to determine the present value of the series. 1 over 1 minus x is the value of our series. So, and this is our x here. So present value is going to be 1,000 times 1 plus 0.05 over 12 to the negative 12 times 1. We have to leave this because this here only represents the series, so only represents this whole thing here in brackets. So if you've got this multiplied out in front, you have to leave it. So we're going to do that, but then we're going to multiply times 1 over 1 minus x here, which represents the series. So 1 plus 0.05 over 12 to the negative 12 right there. So that should be our present value. And when we do the math in our calculator, and that would be something that you need to be very careful about, I recommend starting from the inside here and doing this in your calculator and then working out instead of plugging the whole thing in. But when we plug all that into our calculator, the value that we get for the series is 19,545.80, which is the amount that we must invest now for the fund to pay us $1,000 at the end of every year forever.